Now, I'm kind of mad at myself for not doing this video earlier because, to put it simply, this guy is nothing but a superstar. Now, as you can see from the title, I'm talking about Juice WRLD. This is an artist that has been buzzing all over the internet for around 2 months now. The song that put him on the map is called All Girls Are The Same, which was directed by none other than Cole Bennett. I admit it, another hoe got me finished, broke my heart, oh no you didn't, fuck sipping. If I had to describe Juice WRLD's music in one sentence, then it would be emotional music that sounds amazing musically speaking, mixed with a lot of great and refreshing melodies. Apart from the fact that he's very talented, he also has a really great singing voice. One thing I like about his actual vocals is the fact that they come with that kind of raspy and organic sound that not a lot of people can pull off except for someone like Post Malone, or in this case, Juice WRLD. Speaking of Post Malone, I feel like Juice WRLD is in that singing slash rapping lane that Post is very much well known for. And when I heard his music for the first time, Posty was actually the first person that I could think of. But as I've been listening to his music more and more, I'm kind of realizing that the raspiness in his voice is what's making him sound similar to Post, and he doesn't exactly sound like him. I like how we're kind of seeing more and more artists coming into the hip-hop culture who are kind of breaking the barrier between what's hip-hop and rap and what's not. In one of my recent videos, I talked about Scarlord, who is one of those artists who goes against the grain and mixes something like metal with rap, and he does a really good job at it. And that in itself does cause a little bit of confusion. But of course, it's the good type of confusion because it makes the artist hard to define and hard to put in a box. But I feel like Juice WRLD falls into that exact space because in his music, there will be moments where you ask yourself, is he a rapper or is he a singer? And that's simply because he has a way of putting R&B, rap, and hip hop all together on one track, and the end result is just beautiful. I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love it. Now, that song that I just played you is called Lucid Dreams. On Lucid Dreams, Juice WRLD is talking about a past lover that broke his heart. He's thinking about her to the point of lucid dreaming about the experience of the heartbreak. And lucid dreaming, as we know, is basically the process of being aware that one is dreaming, and you are so aware to the point where you can't even take it as far as changing the outcome of your dream. And Juice does actually have a couple of references about this exact thing on the track. I have these lucid dreams where I can't move a thing. It's crazy how much potential I see in Juice WRLD. I truly believe that he's gonna flourish into one of the biggest artists, if not the biggest new artist that has came out in 2018. One thing I really like about his music is the fact that he has a very grown way of addressing his relationship issues, considering that he's only 19 years old. The level of maturity that I'm hearing from him is kind of amazing, honestly. It's almost like the music he's producing serves as some kind of therapy for the listener, because he talks about his relationship issues with so much passion. It seems like to me that he's using music as a way to set himself free from all the troubles in his own life, and he does that by giving the listener, us, something we can listen to.
I'm not necessarily the most joyful person in the world, but that's one thing that does make me happy, making music, especially that other people could relate to. And that makes them see, that makes them happy. It's like good energy.
I love the very bouncy flow that Juice always seems to be bringing on his tracks. Regardless of the fact that most of his tracks have a very sad and kind of cloudy type of atmosphere, he really provokes a different emotion out of me than just the word sad. Obviously, if you do take the time to analyze some of his lyrics, you'll realize that most of what you're hearing isn't things that are supposed to make you happy or excited, so to speak. But for some strange reason, I'm still getting that quote unquote light at the end of the tunnel feeling from just listening to what Juice has to say on his record. I know I'm not right, but I'm not wrong. No, I'm not wrong. Girl, you hate it when I'm too high, but that's where I belong. Where I belong. Now, I said it on Twitter and I'm gonna say it again. This is a very, very, very talented individual we have right here. Juice WRLD is basically a walking broken heart, and his art is so powerful that he makes you emotionally invested in the stories that he's telling in his music. Honestly, as I'm listening to his music and I'm getting a piece of his own story, I'm hearing and I'm seeing a person who, despite their young age, has been through a lot and has a lot to share with the world. In a way, I kind of see a part of myself in Juice WRLD.
Ooh, that was very deep.
And I think that's probably why I'm gravitating so much towards him. There's just something very honorable about a person who shares exactly what they're feeling to millions and millions of people. And I really think that vulnerability that he's carrying inside of him with pride is what's gonna set himself apart from the rest. And yeah, that's exactly why Juice WRLD is a superstar.